at church. But Reformation was not this. They wanted to reform the church. They weren't talking about bringing back the gifts to the church, the signs and the wonders back to the church. They were talking about Reformation. And their progeny followed them along with Augustine, the Baptist, the Methodist, the Baptist, the Presbyterian, and the Lutheran. Followed along Luther, John Calvin, and saying that tongues and gifts had ceased in the church. But somebody must have forgotten to tell God what he couldn't do. But around 1831, a famous Presbyterian pastor named Irvin started a revival of tongues in the church, and they condemned him. Somebody forgot to tell God that he never leaves himself without a witness. And around the 18th century, an Anglican priest, my God, influenced by Moravians, his heart felt strangely warm. His name just Wesley. He was looking for a deeper relationship with God. He was looking for holiness when he found a Methodist. And he planted the seeds for the holiness movement. John Wesley, he offered his followers a second blessing. And around in the late 1800s and the 19th century, there were holy Methodists that started a full-blown holiness movement. Because they believe that if God is real, you ought to be able to feel it sometimes. If God is real, you ought to be more than just sit up and cross your legs like you got it all going. If God is real, he'll make you cry when he opens your mind. Find yourself running, nobody chasing you. When it's real, you ought to be able to feel something. And around the late 1800, around the early 1900, Benjamin Irvin found a baptized holiness. Offered his followers a third lesson. He started talking about the fire in the church. This is starting to look more and more like that. And along with Charles Parham and various different ones from the holiness movements began to call themselves Pentecostals. And their inspiration was the day of Pentecost. Miracles, signs, and wonders were coming back in the church. This was looking more and more like that. Called themselves Pentecostals. And it reached ahead whenever Charles Parham, at the request of Agnes Osman, laid hands on her on Christmas Eve, and she spoke in Chinese for 3 days, trying to write something she wrote in Chinese. They started calling themselves Pentecostals. But it reached ahead when Parham moved to Texas, and a white-eyed black man was sitting on the outside listening to the message. He moved his camp to California, and it was out on Azusa Street. He wasn't intellectual. He wasn't all that smart. He didn't say he just preached Jesus. He didn't talk about name and claim it, jab it, stab it, grab it. We just had it, y'all ain't stealing got it. He wasn't talking about I'm too blessed to the script. He was just preaching Jesus. Folks like Charles Mason, founder of Church of God in Christ, followed out the Wesley's second lesson. But then there was William Durham from the Baptist background that said, no, there ain't no second or third lesson. It's just finished works. Jesus finished it at the cross. And the of God. And they said, we ain't going to argue about doctrine. We're not going to hold it over nobody's head. But whenever you release folk to serve God, you release them for the Holy Spirit to start using them. Preachers like Grimes and Ben Cook started talking about the baptism in Jesus' name. They went back to the modalistic view that Jesus is God. He's one Lord, one faith. They start preaching because these holiness Pentecostals believed that not only should you feel God, not only should you work miracles, but you ought to be able to act like that. Yeah, yeah. Of God. My God, and it reached the head when one of their prolific preachers, prolific songwriter, G.T. Hayward, was reading on one of this article entitled Meet in Due Season. And G.T. Hayward invited Glenn Cook to preach in his church. When Glenn Cook preached, the 500 plus members of G.T. Hayward's organization from the Assemblies of God went down in Jesus' name. Lord have mercy. The Assemblies of God said, you got to get out of here. They put him out. And along with that group, they started what's called the Pentecostal Assemblies of the World. In other words, P-A-W. And P-A-W, G.T. Hayward had a member of his congregation named R.C. Lawson. And in 1919, R.C. Lawson, I feel praise coming on. In 1919, R.C. Lawson started a church of our Lord Jesus Christ. And I thank God for the succession of leadership. Apostle Bishop Spencer, Chief Apostle Bonner, Bishop Gruber, Bishop Clark, and Bishop Norwood. And we keep on going forward with God. But in 1948, we caught it in the defense of the gospel. R.C. Lawson preached a message entitled